They're animals you simply shouldn't be messing with. Chief among them are big cats and snakes. Like in this sighting in a Live Life African safari, it seemed the leopard was just curious about something it saw in the grass. Perhaps its next meal? Nope, it's a giant African rock python. Not happy about being disturbed, the rock python attacks. Who do you think wins this round? African rock pythons are the largest species of snake in Africa. They live in grasslands near water, and sometimes in forest edges of sub-Saharan Africa. Yeah, they're non-venomous, but that doesn't mean they aren't dangerous. On the contrary, they're a highly invasive species, and have managed to dam in the ecosystem in the Florida Everglades. They eat animals the size of antelopes and crocodiles, so a leopard isn't a huge task. The battle breaks out, and for a while, it looks like the leopard would lose it. The python had started wrapping its coil around the big cat and suffocating it, but the leopard managed to jump out of its grasp and start clawing at the snake. Both animals resort to their classic combat strategies to survive, but they both also know there can be only one winner. In the end, the python loses with several wounds on its body. The leopard has quite a few too, with one obvious gash on the right front paw. Reports say it left with a limp, and it was undoubtedly the most incredible fight they'd ever seen. Pythons can be pretty sneaky too. It's a hot day in Maharashtra, India, and all this deer wants is some water. So it leans close to the lake to quench its thirst, but quickly spots something unusual. So do his friends, apparently. "Oh, it's probably nothing," one of them says and continues drinking. Famous last words. The python pops out and grabs the smallest of them in a flash. The rest run away while this little guy is dragged into the water. The python circles around the prey and starts squeezing. You can see the deer can't even struggle anymore. Yikes! This leopard creeps up from the side, but it knows to keep its distance. It sits down, unsure of what to do next, while the python basks in the sunshine, perhaps knowing the leopard is close by. Snakes have a powerful sense of smell. In fact, it's one of the most powerful in the animal kingdom. And it isn't just the nose that helps them capture smell and identify it. They've taken the route of their lepidosaurian ancestors, who adapted their tongues to capture scent particles from the air and transfer them into olfactory information. Many lizards have this talent, but only a few really use it to its full extent. This guy is probably a little tired of waiting around, so it circles to the front to agitate this snake, which really is just peacefully minding its own business. The snake warns it away, which causes him to retract for a split second before pawing at it anyway. It looks like this python isn't seeking a fight, so it moves away but ends up caught by the neck in the leopard's mouth. For a moment, it looks like the snake is dead, as the leopard drags it into the thicket to enjoy a hearty meal. But as snakes do, it gives the big cat the slip and ducks into the water. And the leopard is left sadly looking into the water. The python may have let that go, but its cousin is certainly seeking its revenge on big cats. Except this guy isn't so big. It's a baby lion, relatively new to the harsh realities of the world. This snake attacks the lion cub, but not one to give up, the cub fights back. Clearly, the cub needs some backup, which arrives soon enough, and the three of them gnaw at the snake to force it to retreat. The lions lick their wounds, and the baby who was attacked gets some reassuring kisses from his mother. Aww. But there are times when a snake really doesn't want to fight, but they're forced into it. Just like people who seem pretty calm about everything until someone really messes with them. This snake gives several warning signs to this tiger that it wants to be left alone. But the tiger apparently took it to be a challenge. Finally, after several attempts to get on the snake's last nerves, he succeeds. If you call succeeding as being caught in a vice-like grip of a python, the snake wraps itself around the tiger tightly, and the big cat is now a tiny house cat. Oh, he tries to escape, tries really hard, but sorry, buddy, you had your chance. The tiger eventually falls limp in the snake's grip and dies. At least the snake is compensated with a meal. Now, can a python eat a lion? Absolutely. We've seen them eat cows and pigs and deer. A lion should be no problem. But oftentimes, what you don't see is the repercussions of eating a meal too big. Many think snakes squeeze around their prey to stop them from breathing, and their victims die from lack of oxygen. Well, that's not the case at all. They're actually trying to induce a heart attack. During its long, slow squeeze, constrictor snakes feel every last heartbeat of their prey, and it uses that information to decide when it's time to let go. They're apparently less worried about over-squeezing their prey into a mushy meal and more concerned about the energy it takes to kill them. I mean, obviously, you don't want to work too hard to kill someone. It's almost not worth it at that point. Jokes aside, constriction requires a lot of effort, and it's potentially dangerous. In the wild, a python has to constrict a rat, a tiny little rat, for 20 minutes. And if a rat takes that much work, imagine trying to constrict and kill a black jaguar. Or a human. African rock pythons aren't the only snakes that are incredibly invasive. For example, the Burmese pythons, native to Burma, found their way to Florida and took over the Everglades ecosystem. It's gotten so bad that some of the local species are close to extinct, and residents of Florida are encouraged to simply shoot these pythons on site. In their natural habitat in Southeast Asia, Burmese pythons are known to kill and eat leopards. And in the Everglades, while there are no leopards, there certainly are Florida panthers. Trying its luck, this snake slithers up to the panther. Curious, the cat moves closer and tries to sniff it. A fatal mistake. Typically, a well-placed bite from a Florida panther to the head would spell doom. But this one seems to lack confidence because the snake is a newcomer to the land. It growls at the unwelcome guest and pokes around a while longer, probably looking for a neck to bite into. Eventually, the cat wises up and leaves the snake alone. And a good thing, too. We really can't afford to lose any more panthers. There are only about 120 to 130 of them left in the wild, which is a dangerously low number. Sometimes, snakes get what's coming to them. This footage is from the Sabi Sabi Reserve, and it looks like the leopard has earned itself a nice big meal. He expertly scales the tree as it holds the dead snake in its jaws. Looks like it was quite a fight, too, seeing as how the snake is basically mutilated. It was probably revenge for Zeta and her leopard cub, who barely survived a vicious python attack. This python attacked a baby leopard and consumed it, right in front of his mother, who was helpless. It wasn't just one cub. The snake ate two of the three cubs Zeta had. The mommy leopard picked up her cub and started looking for a safe place to hide, all the while trying to keep the agitated little cub calm. Needless to say, the mother didn't leave her cub alone for a second after that. How heartbreaking. What do you think of these snakes? Is nature just taking its course? Or are they genuinely just mean animals? Tell us your thoughts in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and hit the like button and check out our channel for more videos just like it. Thanks for watching.